Hey folks, a record-shattering day across the valley today, a day when every major reporting station broke a record. McAllen's old record was 105, and today made it to 109. West Lago, we got to 106. That broke the old record of 102. That was set in 2000, and the 106 is the hottest we've been since June 22nd of last year, so it's been over a year since we've been this hot. Harlingen made it to 106. That broke a record. Brownsville and Port Isabel both got to 102. The records were 98, so everybody in the valley that reports officially setting records today. It's still 90 in McAllen, Rio Grande City, even at this hour. 85 Harlingen and Raymondville, Port Isabel, 86 in Brownsville right now. Still feels like it's close to 100. It does still feel like 100 in Brownsville because dew points are way up right now. And with the high dew point, that's what really makes it feel hot. And the dew points are up in the upper 70s. And with that, tonight's lows are not going to drop much below 80 across the entire valley. The beach bottoms out about 82. Here's, I guess, the good news, if you will. Tomorrow, not quite as hot as today. It's weird to say 102, and that's not as hot. And that's a full 7 degrees cooler than today in McAllen. Brownsville about 97. That's 5 degrees cooler than today. So a pretty good cool down, relatively speaking, across the area for tomorrow. Still above average. The normal's 96. Will be 100. And then we actually bring readings down to 98 for Thursday and Friday and introduce isolated showers to the forecast. An old dying front. It's kind of sneaking across South Texas tonight, but it triggered some showers and thunderstorms to the north of us, up to the north of Corpus Christi, back around Laredo. Those are long gone tonight, but I think there's enough moisture around tomorrow for maybe a stray, isolated, single shower someplace in the valley, but most of us stay dry tomorrow. I think Thursday is a pretty dry day and probably not quite as hot. And then Friday, I think there's a slightly better chance of a few showers on Friday, where the rain chance is going up just a little bit, but not a lot. Looks like our shot on Friday is probably, right now we got 10%. It may go up just a little bit. Here's a look at tomorrow. You saw a couple of green splotches show up. Thursday, we don't see much green at all. Something tries to form in camp. But then Friday, model's a little more aggressive with bringing a few showers in during the afternoon. So we'll see if maybe we can sneak a couple of showers in on Friday. Holding at 10% right now. Tropics, absolutely nothing for the next 5 days, about as quiet as it can be. If you're headed to our coast, here's what you can expect. Easterly winds relatively light. The chop is light. UV is extreme. 91 for your high at the beach. There's a low risk of rip currents there with the tides. So 80 for a low tonight, mainly clear, warm and muggy. The clouds that are out there now will get out of here later on. Then tomorrow, partly sunny and hot. About a 10% chance of a brief shower, south to southeast winds at about 10 to 20. So we do take temperatures down a little bit for Thursday and Friday, and then 100 on Saturday and Sunday again. By the middle of next week, some of the models are indicating another shower threat. So none of these isolated shower threats are a big deal, but at least a slight possibility of something in there. And tomorrow, nobody should reach 109. So big cool down.